Ladies and gentlemen, what is going on and welcome to another video. My name is Nathaniel Morton and I am a sports performance coach who specializes in basketball players. And in today's video, we got a question from NC Rich who says, should you do the same vertical jump workouts every time that you train vertical? No, you definitely shouldn't. You should switch it up. But before I get into the video and before I explain this, make sure that you comment jump, J-U-M-P down below in the comment section if you want a free vertical jump training program, and link down below in the description and in the pinned comment is my personal coaching and my programs. If you want me to coach you to a hard vertical jump, you can go ahead, click that link, sign up, and I will take you to the next level. So the answer to that question is no, you don't want to do the same vertical jump workouts every single time, but you do want to have a handful of staple exercises, the most important exercise that you can do to increase your vertical jump. By the way, I either have a video coming or it might already be posted, but depending on when you watch this video, of the 20 best exercises that you could possibly do for vertical jump. So those will be considered the staples. Now, you're not gonna do those every single time, but you are going to repeatedly go back to these exercises because they are the meat and potatoes, the best exercises that you can do to increase your vertical jump. So I'll personally tell you what I do for my athletes and then what I do myself. Now, just to keep it 100% authentic between you and I, here's what I do when I do my programming. I have my staples. I have my squats, my deadlifts, my step-ups, my power cleans, my sprints, my jumping. I have these exercises that I do almost within my programming. It's not going to be every single workout, but it's going to be every other workout, or it's going to be once a week, or these exercises I repeatedly come back to. But when it comes to plyometrics, I like to play around. Okay, so 70 to 80% of my workouts, I do these staple workouts every single time. But about 20 to 30% of my workouts, I might look on Instagram at PGF Performance or Overtime Athletes or some other plyometrics that I find, the lost breed of some crazy stuff that just looks fun, and I might add them in. So I made another video on which category of your exercises should be in which order during any vertical jump workout. So during a workout, you gotta start with your warm-up, then you do your speed exercises, then your power, then your strength, then your hypertrophy, then your rehab or your prehab. When it comes to those first speed exercises and the plyometrics, I like to mess around with different types of plyometrics. So always in my programming, I'm going to have some depth jumps or some sprints or some approach jumps. But if I see some crazy stuff that I just saw on Instagram and I just want to try because it looks fun, then I will add that in. But your answer is very simple for this video. No, it should not be the same every single time, but you got to have the meat and potatoes. You got to have that handful of exercises that are the best exercises possible for your vertical jump that you come back to every single time, and you try to progressive overload each time you do them. Anyways, like, comment, subscribe, comment, jump down below for a free vertical jump training program, and get my coaching in the pinned comment. And I will see you guys in the next video.
Young Beast Mode from the East Coast. A young kid with a West Coast feel, and I don't even know how the West Coast feel. I'm from where it's cold. The city made of steel, where a lot of fold, only couple keep it real right. Back seal, keep it real tight. Keep two L's just like Cool J. My heart's cold as ice cube. Praying it's a good day. I'm at a crossroads, but in a good way. I got my